water has been the sustaining source for the people of Ardmore throughout the generations. Ardmore is a coastal village, the most southerly in Waterford. Ardmore has a connection with the sea as a place of sustenance and industry. Salmon has been fished here for the past 100 years, as the seasons became shorter and the licenses more expensive. Many of the locals went to Leinster House in protest, but to no avail. Deep sea fishing for sharks went on, as well as for lobster and crab. Few still fish here now for a living. In the past, the sea was a place of possibility, as ships wrecked in the bay and mines and refugees from the wars floated in. Ardmore's bounty now lies upon the beaches, instead of in the depths. 5 beaches draw people from afar for their tranquility and relief from the occasional Irish sun. Ardmore, Curra, Ballyquin, Goat Island, Whiting Bay. Ardmore Village is nestled at the tip of a crescent bay between Ramhead and Minehead, one long stretch of beachfront divided into 3 by a smaller head and rocks. These beaches face east, protecting them from the strong southern swells. What we're left with is gentle waves and a glassy surface. But not all visitors to Ardmore have had a tranquil visit. 17 ships were torpedoed and sunk off Ardmore between February 1917 and September 1918. The SS Folia was a cargo ship operating from Avonmouth to New York. On March 11, 1917, passing the Irish coast, the third officer spotted a submarine lying in wait. Before they could respond, they were torpedoed, killing 7 of the crew. The survivors fled into the lifeboat as the German submarine U-53 rose to the surface and shelled the vessel. A final torpedo sank the ship. 63 survivors made it off the ship onto the lifeboats and travelled north into Ardmore Bay. The locals were emerging from mass and received them wholeheartedly, welcoming them into their homes and providing anything they required. They were rewarded for their hospitality with the cargo that floated into the village in the following months. The SS Bandon was not so lucky. The following month, April 1917, the SS Bandon was en route from Liverpool to Cork when they were torpedoed off the coast of Minehead. The ship exploded due to damage to the engine room and quickly sank. 28 of the crew were killed. 6 men managed to survive the blast and grabbed hold of a deck seat. One man was unable to hold on to the raft and joined the crew beneath the water's surface. As the rescue boat arrived, a wave threw another man back into the water as he attempted to grab the rope to safety and was drowned. 4 men survived the attack. Survivors weren't the only thing to float into the bay. A sea mine floated into Ardmore one day and crept its way towards the storm wall. Onlookers watched as it threatened to blow the wall to smithereens, but instead was carefully deposited onto Ardmore Beach. Its safe deliverance was attributed to St. Declan. Mines continued to float ashore during the war, and the Gardaí warned that if any more mines were to come ashore, the village should be evacuated. The treachery of the sea extended beyond the war. 1947 was the year of the big snow. Arctic winds tore across the country and a great blizzard covered the country in snow. The temperatures rarely rose above freezing for 3 months. Ireland was short on fuel and a steamer named the SSRI left Wales bound for Waterford Port carrying 600 tons of coal. Rough seas battered the ship and the weight of the coal began to shift. The captain tried to flood the cargo store, balancing the weight, but had no luck. The ship was doomed. He ordered the ship to be abandoned and 9 made it into the lifeboats and into the sea, whilst the other 6 crew went down with the ship. The lifeboat had no engine, oars, or supplies. Jan Dorutski, a Polish man aged 19, was one of the survivors drifting during the night. He went to sleep under a tarp and awoke in the morning to find his fellow crew dead beside him, passing during the night from exposure. Fearing their bodies, he pushed them into the sea and floated towards the shores of Minehead. He stumbled, frostbitten, to a local house, where he was then taken to Dungarvan for treatment. Jan's legs were amputated, having suffered badly from frostbite. After his recovery, he returned to Poland. The bodies of the crew had begun to wash upon the shores from Ardmore to Yall. 12 men were buried in Ardmore. The grave was renovated in memorial to the men who lost their lives. These are not the only shipwrecks that litter the Ardmore coast. The Nellie Fleming from Yall landed on Curra Beach in 1913, as did the Maréchal de Noailles near Minehead. A French trawler, the Fille des Ondes, became stranded upon Ardmore Beach in October 1963. The ship remained stranded on Ardmore Beach upon the rocks at low tide. In response to the destruction upon our shores, Brave men worked to help those in the dangerous deep. The first Ardmore Coast Guard station was built in 1836, but has since been washed away by the tide. It began for revenue purposes, and as an anti-smuggling force while also carrying out sea rescue, establishing station number 23 on Ardmore Head. The life-saving services were not as we know them. They had rockets. Rocket launchers shot breech lines into the water with instructions to tie it to the mast. The rockets had a double explosive element. The initial would launch and the secondary explosion would propel it to the ship. Once secured to the mast, a breeches boy would be sent across the line for casualties to be rescued. The Ardmore rocket crew would train at Goat Island, a small cove nestled beyond Ram Head towards Whiting Bay. The island stood as a ship, and the crew would be brought back on the breech boy. In 1911, the schooner Teaser was on voyage from Swansea to Dingle when it was caught in a storm off the coast of the Curragh. The local men spotted it, and a priest, Reverend O'Shea, led a group of men back to the village to find a boat and take to the seas. The men of the Teaser quickly died from exposure, and Reverend O'Shea delivered their last sacraments upon the boat. After the ordeal, the men were awarded medals of gallantry by the King at Buckingham Palace, and Reverend O'Shea received the George Cross, the highest civilian gallantry award. The waters and beaches of Ardmore have sustained the village for a millennia. The sea is a place of danger and opportunity. And as the many men whose presence lingers off the Ardmore coast would attest, it's not to be taken lightly.